Welcome to the Vue Tooltip tutorial. The Syncfusion Vue Tooltip component is a pop-up that shows information or a message when users hover, click, focus on, or touch an image, button, anchor tag, etc. The tooltip can show text, images, hyperlinks, or custom templates. In this video, you will see how to add the Vue Tooltip component to a Vue application. You will also see how to change its position, enable sticky mode, and render the tooltip content using an HTML template. I will start with the application creation process. I'm going to create a Vue application using the vue-v command. I will be using Visual Studio Code as my code editor and viewing outputs in the Microsoft Edge browser. Make sure you have installed the latest versions of Vue and Node.js. To create a project in Vue, I open Visual Studio Code and type the command npm create vue-latest. I provide the app name, my Vue app. Next, I choose Vue as the framework and JavaScript as the variant. The Vue project has been created. I navigate to the newly created Vue app and install the required dependencies using the npm install command. Now the application is configured with the default settings of a Vue project. To add the Syncfusion Vue Tooltip component, I install the Syncfusion Vue Popups package using the npm install at syncfusion/ej2vue-popups --save command. This command will install the Vue Popups package along with its dependencies. Once the installation is completed, the application is ready to use. The first thing I must do here is register the trial license key to use the Syncfusion components. I open the main.js file and import the register license method from the Syncfusion EJ2 base package. Using this method, I register the trial license key. To see how to generate the license key, refer to the link in the description below. The application is now configured to use Syncfusion Vue components. To start using the Vue Tooltip component, I open the App Vue page and remove the default code snippets. I import the Vue Tooltip component from the Syncfusion EJ2 Vue Popups package. I plan to display a tooltip when hovering over a button. To achieve this, I install the Syncfusion EJ2 Vue Buttons package using the npm install at syncfusion/ej2vue-buttons --save command. Next, I import the button component using the Syncfusion EJ2 Vue Buttons package. To apply CSS styles to the tooltip and button components, I import the necessary material theme CSS references. Then I add the tooltip component by adding EJ's tooltip tag. Within it, I add a division element with the ID container and add a button component within it. I set its content as show tooltip. To display the tooltip while hovering on the button, I set an ID to the button component and set that ID to the target property of the tooltip. Next, I set the desired content for the tooltip using the content property. Then, align the tooltip component by adding a few CSS styles, such as display, position, and left inside the style tag. I save the changes and run the application using the npm run dev command. Seed the button component with a text show tooltip, and when I hover, the tooltip is displayed. By default, the tooltip is placed at the top center of the target element. You can customize the position to 12 static locations around the target, like right center, bottom center, and so on. To change the tooltip's position to right center, I set the position property to right center. When I hover the button, the tooltip is shown at the right center position. Notice that the tooltip disappears when I move out of the button. The tooltip can be kept open as long as the mouse hovers. To achieve this, I set the isticky property to true. See now, when I hover over the button, the tooltip is shown and remains there even when I move out of the button control. I can close the tooltip using this close button. So far, I've shown you how to render a tooltip with a simple string. Now let me show you how to render the tooltip content using an HTML template. I define a template tag with a vslot directive and name it as content template. Within it, I add a set of HTML elements. These elements consist of a header tag, an anchor tag, and an image tag to display a heading, a website link, and an image within the tooltip. I then assign this content template to the content property. When I hover over the button, you can see the customized tooltip with the HTML content in it. In this video, I have shown you how to add the tooltip component to a Vue application. I have also shown you how to change its position, enable sticky mode, and render the tooltip content using an HTML template. If you would like to see a working example of this, you can download it from the GitHub link in the description below. I have also shared a link where you can learn about obtaining a free license key to use our Vue suite if you are eligible for our community license. Thank you for watching this video. If you found it helpful, please give it a like and subscribe to our channel.